Hello and welcome to the class. So in the last two sessions we covered almost 21 questions for the paper 2 extended October-November 2019. Today we'll cover 21 onwards questions, and in case of any doubt then you can comment. So I'm starting with the question number 22. For the rest of the questions you can see my last two videos. Okay, so question number 22. A pipe is completely full of water. Water flows through the pipe at a speed of this one. So this is speed is given. So speed is equals to 1.2 meter per second. The cross section area. So area is also given. Area is equals to 6 centimeter square. The question is how much liter of water, that means volume. Volume is how much. So volume is equals to area of cross section into length of pipe. We can use this, but we can see there is a difference of unit in this scenario. What I will do, we know 1000 centimeter cube is equals to 1 liter, so I will convert this meter per second into the centimeter per hour. So how I will do, so 1 meter is equals to 1 centimeter, 100 centimeter, and 1 second is equals to, I can write 3600 hour. So I am going to write here 1/3600 hour. So what will be the answer? 1.2 into 1000, sorry, into 100 into 3600 centimeter per hour. Now we have the required value. So when we multiply, what we will get, we can write here 4320 centimeter per hour. Okay, so this is our speed, that means this is our length, and the area is already given. I will do substitution of these two, 432 followed by 3 zeros, and divide by 1000 in order to get into the liter. So if I cut this and this, I can cancel this, and answer is 2592 liter. So this is like how, first of all we need to understand like how we can convert into the same unit, what is the required unit here, and we can convert and then we can substitute the values in the formula. Okay, so moving to the next question. Question number this. So this is based on the set theory. So A intersection. Intersection is like the common. What is common between A and B? So you can see here, intersection is like common. So what is common? 2 is common, because 2 is there, and 5 is common. So I can write here 2, 5. These two are common. Intersection is what is common between them. N of B, that means the number of B. So how many numbers are there? 3. So I'm writing here 3. Now 0, 4, 6 is equals to intersection of what? So this is what A and this is what B. What I can write? B dash is what? B complementary is what? Other than 1, 2, 5? Other than 1, 2, 5 is like 0, 3, 4 and 6. Right? And what we have A? A is 0, 2, 4, 5 and 6. Now if you see what is common between them, 0 is common, 4 is common and 6 is common. So we can write here, it is what? A intersection B dash. Okay. Now 2, 4 is a part of, or it belongs to A. So is a part of, is a part of, this is a symbol of, is a part of. Okay. So this is like how we can solve the set theory questions. Now functions question. Now we are moving to the functions question. So f of g is this one and f g of x is this one. Find f g. So first of all I will write here f g of x. What is f g of x? So f of x is 3. Wherever x is there, I will replace with g of x minus 5, like this. This was our, if you see 3x minus 5, when x was there, instead of x I replaced with g of x, then 3 g of x minus 5. What is value of g of x? 2 raised to power x. So I will put here 2 raised to power x minus 5. So this is our f g of x. Now I have to put the value f g of 3. So f g of 3, that means we have to put 2 raised to power 3 minus 5. 2 raised to power 3 is 8, 18 to 3 24. So 24 minus 5 is equals to 19. Okay, so this is like how we can go for the substitution. F inverse, so write y is equals to 3x minus 5. This was, you can see this is f of x. And now I will find the value of x first. So y, I will shift this 5 over here. Then I can write here 3x. X is equals to y plus 5 upon 3. Now I can write this is our f inverse of x. Replace y with x. X plus 5 upon 3. So answer is x plus 5 upon 3. So this is like how we can find out f inverse of x. You have to write y is equals to the function and then find some, make the subject x and then replace the value of y by x, and x you can write f inverse of x. So f inverse of x. Okay. Now moving to the next topic, vector. So vector, if vector triangle, if there is A, this is what B and this is what C. So it, I can write here like AB, then plus B to C, then plus C to A is always equals to 0. Why? Because vector is a vector, it is a vector quantity, so it has direction. So when starting point and finish point is same, like end point is same, then we can say sum of this, because we started from this one and ending at this point. That means the net displacement is 0. So that's why we can write this one. Now how we can find BA? So there is relation between like OP is equals to twice of OA, and OA is not given but OP is P. So I can write P is equals to 2 OA, or OA is equals to P upon 2. Similarly, OQ is equals to what we can write here. OQ is equals to 3OB. Now what is given here? OB is given. No, OQ is given. So I can write Q is equals to 3OB, or we can write OB is equals to Q upon 3. So this is like how we can find out. Okay, now BA, we have to find out this BA part. Okay, so how we can find out? I'm just changing this. So consider here, can we write like this? OB plus BA plus AO is equals to 0, like this. Now OB, we know, we already calculated OB is Q upon 3, plus BA we don't know, we need to identify AO. So AO is not given, OA is given. So if I'm going to write OA, then I have to take negative sign, okay, is equals to 0. So BA is equals to, I can write minus OA, when it goes to another side, it becomes plus minus Q upon 3. What is value of OA? P by 2. So BA is equals to P by 2 minus Q by 3. So answer is P by 2 minus Q by 3. This is like how we can, so this is like how we can find out the value of BA. Now vector position of OM, that means we need to find out OM. So how we can find out this is our OM? So for that we have to find out this value. Okay, so this value we'll find out. So first of all we need to identify the QP. So can we write like in triangle this OQM, OQ plus QP plus PO is equals to 0. Okay, now OQ is, we know OQ is already given, it's Q. QP is not given, and PO, it's OP is given. So I'm writing a minus, and value of OP is P is equals to 0. So QP we can write P minus Q. Okay, now QMM is the midpoint for both the values. So I'm going to take QM is equals to MP is equals to half of this, right? Now I'm going to consider this small triangle, okay, OM plus MP plus PO. So OM plus MP plus PO is equals to 0, OM, we don't know, we need to identify, is equals to minus MP and minus PO. Now I can write minus MP. So MP value of minus MP is given, so I am writing here minus P. Okay, and minus PO, so I will write plus OP. Why? Because I am changing the direction. Okay, now value of OP we have to substitute. What is value of OP? Here I am opening the bracket, minus P plus Q upon 2, OP is P. So it's like 2P minus P plus Q upon 2. So answer is like P plus Q upon 2. So I can write here position vector of M is P by 2 plus Q by 2, or you can write P plus Q upon 2 for both divided by 2. Okay. Okay, so now moving to the next one. So this is last question. So speed time graph is given. So area of speed time gives us the total distance traveled. So that means if I'm going to consider this is area 1 and this is area 2. So A1 in this case, this is what rectangle. So it's easy, 20 into 15, which is 300 in this case. But what about A2? A2 is like half into base into height, but this height is missing in this case. So question is given, decelerating a car travel 20 meter per second for 15 seconds and it comes to the rest. That means this is velocity is 0 and here it is velocity is this. So initial velocity is 20, final velocity is 0. Decelerating, so acceleration is minus 2.5. So we can find out the time. Why? How? V is equals to u plus at. So v is 0, u is 20 minus 2.5 into time. So t is equals to, it is 20 upon 2.5. okay, so 20 upon 2.5 is 8. So time is 8. So that means this distance is 8. Sorry, this time is 8. That means 23 seconds. So in this case, now we have this value. We have, sorry, this was already given 20. This was not given. So now A2 I can write here half into base into height. So half base in this case is 8. Height is 20. Okay. So what I'm going to do, just cancel this one. So answer is 80. So total area is A1 plus A2, which is equals to 300 plus 80, 380 meter. So this is the distance traveled by the object, total distance traveled by the object. So I can write here 300 meter. So thank you for watching. In the next video, I will solve another paper, and in case of any doubt, you can reach out to us, share and subscribe. And if you like, then please comment. Thank you.